Hi everyone, and welcome to Good Friday here at Riverview Church. We're really excited that you've chosen to be with us today as we come and we sit and gather around the Lord's table. Today we're going to experience and participate in song, in scripture, and in the wonder of sacrifice. And to help you make the most of this Good Friday experience, we want to encourage you to get a Bible and a notepad and to find something that you can take for communion. Anything will do, so look around in your cupboard and find what you need. We want to share in this experience together. And you know, whilst we may be gathered in homes all across the city, we get to sit around the same table and share in the same communion meal. And so to start our time off together today, we're going to read together from Luke 22. So Cheryl, would you read this for us?
Luke chapter 22, verses 7 to 13. Then came the day of unleavened bread, on which the Passover lamb had to be sacrificed. Jesus sent Peter and John, saying, "Go and make preparations for us to eat the Passover." "Where do you want us to prepare for it?" they asked. He replied, "As you enter the city, a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him to the house that he enters, and say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher asks, where is the guest room? Where may we eat the Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a large room upstairs, all furnished. Make preparations there." They left and found things just as Jesus had told them. So they prepared the Passover.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son,
chapter 22, verses 14 to 16. When the hour came, Jesus and his apostles reclined at the table. And he said to them, I have eagerly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I tell you, I will not eat it again until it finds fulfillment in the kingdom of God.
Thank you. In the lead up to the cross, all four gospel writers take time to tell us about this moment when Jesus and his disciples go into that upper room for what we know as the Last Supper, but what Jesus and his first followers would have called Passover, when they came to eat together, to celebrate together the story of their God who had come to their redemption thousands of years before, coming into the life of his people in Egypt to lead them out of slavery and bondage. This meal served to remind them that the God of Abraham and Isaac and Jacob was their Redeemer God. Now in Jesus, this ancient tradition was being made into a new practice. In Jesus, the old was becoming new. This was a new Passover meal. In this meal of bread and wine, the church around the globe gathered together to celebrate a new Exodus. Our Passover lamb is Jesus, and he will take our place on the sacrificial altar called Calvary. This meal will become the celebration and reminder of the freedom that we are invited into through Jesus. The Gospel of John probably spends the most amount of time on documenting the details of this last meal that Jesus has with his followers. In this upper room experience, he teaches them about his kingdom and the kingdom culture, and he demonstrates that by getting on his hands and knees and washing their feet. He teaches them and equips them for life in the next phase of the Exodus journey. He eats with them. He worships his Father with them as they sing psalms together. And no doubt he would have laughed and he would have cried with them as they celebrated the God of Abraham and Isaac and Jacob, and they did it together. Despite the shadow of the cross looming over that upstairs dining hall, it's amazing to me that Jesus takes time to be present with his followers and to join with them in connecting his story to the ancient salvation story of God's people. In the upper room, heaven is touching earth. Eternity is here and now. And in the place of doubt and pride and disconnection, a new story is breaking in. It's a story of freedom, a story of escape, a story of Exodus. It's our story.
Out of my head, oh God, that I bring to you the stuff I don't get. Oh God, that I bring to you the things that I've said.
Of
I bring to you the tears that I shed. Oh God, I bring to you whatever is left.
I've always loved the humanity of this meal. Ordinary people gathered together around an extraordinary Jesus. He's their host. They're all bringing their baggage. They're bringing their hopes. They're bringing their dreams, their disappointment, their confusion, their very real fear and doubt as they get ready to go to Jerusalem. And yet, despite all of this relational baggage, all the emotional strain of this moment on their journey together, we find them eating and drinking in very real proximity to one another and to Jesus. Nobody's disqualified from table fellowship. Even Judas is invited to participate. What grace! The bread is broken, the cup is shared, the vision is cast. The new covenant is here, a covenant of friendship. In that upper room, Jesus explained that everything that he was about to do and go through, everything that he would endure, the violence, the agony, the isolation, and his death was a cosmic act of friendship. Through bread and wine and singing together, he explains that greater love has no man than this, than he lays down his life for his friends. He goes on to explain to his friends in that upper room that they used to be called servants, but now they are his friends. Because you see, through the cross, Jesus is making a way to restore all of creation into friendship with God. That's the invitation that you and I are invited to participate in this Good Friday. In the Old Testament, covenants and agreements between God and his people were mediated by his friends, Adam, Noah, Abraham, Moses, David. But his people were called his servants. But now, through the powerful work of Calvary, an invitation is given to become not just recipients of God's promises, but a mediator of them. He no longer calls us servants. He calls us friends. And we are invited not just into this new Exodus story, but to be participants with him in it, of sharing this story with the world, a story of freedom and healing for the nations. I love that this gathering on this first Good Friday is a gathering of friends. What can be more human? What can be more beautiful than a community of friendship? Flaws, falsehoods, faith, faithlessness, fun, foolishness, and yet all invited to join together in God's redeeming story of friendship with the world. Psalm 118. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Let Israel say, his love endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, his love endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his love endures forever. Amen.
This beautiful plate is one of my favourite things. It's a very special part of the way that my family and friends enter into Good Friday. It's from the Jewish tradition, and it's called a Seder plate. It's designed to help God's people not just tell the Passover story, but to interact with the Passover story through food and through memory. The purpose is not just to tell the Exodus story, but to recognize that we are in the story. This is not a story that happened to people a long time ago, but it's a story that's happening for me right now. At the Passover meal, those around the table look to each other and they say, "Once I was a slave in Egypt. Once I was a slave to sin and death, but now I have been set free." This is what Jesus and his friends were doing on that night around the Passover meal. Over the Passover meal, they were putting themselves into God's salvation story. They were celebrating God's plan to set the captives free. At the Passover meal, Jesus does more than put himself into the story. Jesus is the Exodus story. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. And through his death and resurrection, Jesus sets us free. On the night Jesus was betrayed, he took bread and he took wine and he invited his disciples to recognize and to remember. Through the action of breaking bread and handing out wine, Jesus says, "Recognize me and remember me. Recognize me. I am the Passover Lamb of God. Through my death, you are marked for life. You are marked for life. You are marked for freedom. You are no longer slaves to sin and death." And then Jesus says, "Remember me." What does it mean to remember Jesus? When we remember, we bring the action of the past into this present moment. This is not just a story, it's our present reality. Jesus said, "Remember me," so that we would appropriate right now who he is and what he has done for us in our time. So I invite you to eat and drink, to recognize and remember Jesus, our rescuer, Jesus, our savior, Jesus, our closest friend, Jesus, the perfect love of God poured out for us. Amen.
They laid him down in Joseph.
Our time together by reading once more, this time from Luke 22, verse 37, and then from Isaiah 53. Luke 22, verse 37, this is Jesus speaking. He says, "It is written, he was numbered with the transgressors. And I tell you that this must be fulfilled in me. Yes, what is written about me is reaching its fulfillment." And Isaiah 53 tells us that he grew up before us like a tender shoot and like a root out of dry ground. He had no beauty or majesty to attract us to him. Nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by mankind, a man of suffering and familiar with pain. Like one from whom people hide their faces, he was despised and we held him in low esteem. Surely he took our pain and bore our suffering, yet we considered him punished by God, stricken by him and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to our own way. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before its shearers is silent, so he did not open his mouth. By oppression and judgment, he was taken away. Yet who of his generation protested? For he was cut off from the land of the living. For the transgression of my people, he was punished. He was assigned a grave with the wicked and with the rich in his death, though he had done no violence, nor was any deceit in his mouth. Yet it was the Lord's will to crush him and to cause him to suffer. And though the Lord makes his life an offering for sin, he will see his offspring and prolong his days. And the will of the Lord will prosper in his hand. After he has suffered, he will see the light of life and be satisfied. By his knowledge, my righteous servant will justify many, and he will bear their iniquities. Therefore, I will give him a portion among the great, and he will divide the spoils with the strong, because he poured out his life unto death and was numbered with the transgressors. For he bore the sin of many and made intercession for the transgressors. This is the word of the Lord. And we can say, thanks be to God. Let's pray. God Almighty, all we can do is simply say thank you. Thank you for who you are. Thank you for all that you've done. Lord Jesus, we thank you that whilst we were still sinners, you died for us to set us free. And we thank you, we remember you, we honor you today Lord, thank you for all that you've done through the cross, but all you continue to do in our lives, in our world, in our stories. We remember you today. We honor you today. And we say that we love you today, Lord Jesus. Amen. Amen. Well, hey, thank you so much for joining with us here on Good Friday. We really pray that this has been a blessing to remember the Lord Jesus together. And we really do pray that as you go about your Easter weekend, it is blessed as you continue to do this. And we would love to invite you to come and join us once more on Sunday. We're going to be gathering here all together at Burswood at 9 a.m., 11 a.m., 4 p.m., and 6 p.m. And so we invite you to come and celebrate the resurrection with us. Tickets are available. You can head to rvc.co/Easter. Thank you so much for being with us. God bless everyone, and we will see you on Sunday. Bye. Thank you.